In one case, a developer takes a chunk of land, gives it to the contractor to construct, and then he sells it. The other system is where the developer has everything in his own hand. We follow the second system.
We are actually doing the entire spectrum of the product in-house. Then our dependency on vendors and other contractors ceases.
To ensure that there is no delay in the project, we make the plan right in the beginning as to how much time it would take to finish. Thereafter, we monitor the progress month by month.
You cannot do gimmicks here. You have to deliver. Good times, bad times, you have to be focused on one thing. Delivery on timely basis, so we have to construct.
So whenever I go to site and I see, you know, if I were a customer, what would I like changed in this home? Add on something into the apartment or complex. I don't have to think twice. I immediately ask my team to make a change there and then, and we just go ahead and do it.
Though in these the challenges are more, yet we feel that if we have to finish on time, then this is the only way that we can do.
Quality is not an issue because the guys who have been in the company now, who are on site, actually know the pulse of the customer.
The same team of engineers in one project, you know, takes care of another project. When we have more projects, some of them elevated to a senior position.
We can actually scale up our operation. Suppose we're doing 2 million square feet, that's what we deliver every year. And we want to wrap up to 3 million. All we have to do is we have to build around this core of people. We can increase our bandwidth to do more work. We are always evolving, so we are also exploring how we can adapt to new technology effectively. Labor is going to become so expensive that building houses with humans, like in the West, is going to be next to impossible. We'll have to use machines in the next decade probably.